All right, hello, wine drinking people. Time for more of what I've had to drink yesterday, and we should do a Joseph Phelps Insignia tasting every other month. One of the easiest events we've ever had to sell out, especially since I'll take a bottle of Insignia as your admission. And you got no excuse for not coming to this if you got Insignia, man. And you know, this is just the starting point, the 10 vintages we had on the table. I opened up a 1998 out of my collection, out of Magnum, which was drinking beautifully. And hey, man, we had Domaine Carneros La Reve to start, which I think we sold every bottle we had in the house. Just outstanding, one of the top level Method Champenois, Tête de Cuvée, sparkling wines made in California. And a good time was had by all 16 people there. And plenty of wine, man. We had wine left over until everybody left, 10 o'clock, whenever it was. I don't know. We had a great evening. We started out with the youngsters. Actually, we started out with the old dogs. I always like to show the old wines first. And the 86, the old dog on the table, just over 30 years old. This wine showing exactly what happened to wines back then. They didn't know what Brett was and some of these other kind of things that got into the wine, gave them some, you know, I don't want to say off aromas, because this wine got 3 votes for wine of the night, and a little bit of a Band-Aid kind of medicinal Brett note to the nose. Not off-putting, kind of intriguing. What you find in a lot of old Bordeaux's, had some eucalyptus, some dry tobacco spice as well, some red currant berry fruit still left in this old dog as well, smooth and silky on the tongue, and a nice zest to the finish, that tobacco spice. And to me, just I would have liked to have had this wine 10 years ago with a little more fruit to it, but it was still quite alive. Like I said, 3 votes for first place. The 1994, now you're getting into the century where these wines, decade rather, where these wines are really starting to drink nicely. 94, 97, and 99 starting to come around finally. 99, a very tannic vintage, the lowest rated wine on the table, but most excellent right now. And that was the only one of the 90s I thought would have been better with a little more age. The 97 just singing right now. This wine got 4 votes for first place, 5 votes for second, making it overall number 2 on the table. But the 94 to me was just as good. Smooth as silk, that mint chocolate chip kind of cookie note shape, pencil lead, some currants, and just smooth and round tannins here. This wine drinking at or near its peak, both in 94 and 97. For my taste, some people thought they needed more time. And like I said, the 99 is the only one I would have kept longer. 2000, a great vintage to open and drink now. Wine showing that eucalyptus, that herbal and tobacco note, and currant berry fruit, smooth as silk on the tongues, that lovely herbal and minty character lasting through the finish. And hey, this wine got 2 votes for second place, the one of the least expensive Insignias you'll find. The 01, wow, most excellent. 01 and 02 to me. You could still go a little longer, but this is when I think these wines start to peak. 10, 15 years in that range. And the 01 a little bit smoother. Hey, the 02, we served out a half bottle. And wine of the night, man. Wow, 6 votes for first, 1 vote for second. And didn't matter which bottle you got, they were very consistent. The 02, a blockbuster, just a huge wine, just bursting, oozing with liqueur-like fruit, cigar box spice. Still had some tannins, but after a couple hours, man, this wine just singing in the glass. The 01, a little more drinkable, but also singing. And these were two of my favorite wines. The 03, a little bit more forward and drinkable. These 3s, I mean, not as good of a vintage as 1 or 2, and it showed in a lineup like this. The 5, wow, a blockbuster. This wine just starting to drink nicely. You definitely could keep this wine 10 more years easily, definitely on the young side, as was the 06. The 06 still had some tannins left in it, a big wine, but a lot of luscious fruit here, very well balanced. Long finish. This wine you will put in your cellar for another 10 years. Most excellent juice. Everything on the table showed very well. Like I said, I opened up a Magnum of 98, which, boom, right out of the bottle, just drank beautifully as this 98 vintage does. And a lot of people very critical of that vintage. Hey, they don't have bad vintages, just bad producers. You will not get a bad vintage of Joseph Phelps Insignia. That's what we had to drink at our Insignia Vertical. I'm your host, Andrew Lampasoni, signing off for the Wine Watch, saying, remember, always drink the good stuff first.